Welcome to Driftwood Guitars. I'm Chris Alvarado, and today we're going to do the final assembly on the 2020 38 Songwriters Festival guitar, and I'm going to show you guys how it sounds. right, here it is, guys. This is that guitar you just watched me finish putting together. It's a Grand Session model with a Western Red Cedar top, quilted maple back and sides. It is bound in Hawaiian Koa, and it does have a flame maple neck as well. A 14 fret slot head. We have a Brazilian rosewood bridge, a Macassar ebony fretboard, and the inlay for this year's 38 Songwriters Festival guitar, which is what this is the lyrics to Blackbird, which is just an iconic song. It's beautifully written, and nobody tops the Beatles when it comes to songwriting, maybe except for Bob Dylan. And I wanted to give you guys a good idea of what it sounded like. Let's run down the signal chain of what you guys are hearing. I am recording all of this through a Zoom H6 recorder with two SM81 pencil condenser microphones. They are about a foot away from the soundboard. One is pointed at the 12th fret, one is pointed at the sound hole, and I do have the shotgun mic on the H6 as well, and it's pointed at about the bridge location. It's only mildly in the mix, and I'm using a Sennheiser lav mic that when I am showing you guys the guitar sound, I will have that muted so you can get a true idea of what it sounds like. No compression, no limiters, no effects. So you're hearing the true dry signal, and I hope it gives you guys a good idea of what it sounds like. When I strung it up, which you guys saw in the video, I was really surprised when I first started strumming on this thing on how well it sounds. It, if I was blindfolded, I would swear that it's a Indian rosewood or some sort of rosewood guitar, because it does have so much bottom end. Just to give you an idea of that, here's an open E major chord. And it just rings and rings and rings. I really think that what's attributing to so much of that bottom end is the cedar top. I've never done a cedar topped guitar with maple back and sides, and the two, man, they just really complement one another. You are hearing these are Diodario phosphor bronze light gauge strings, so I just wanted to throw that out there too. Does have that snappiness of maple, which is always lovely, and the projection of maple. Run through the major chords here. With how this thing sounds. What else to say about it? It does have a double carbon fiber reinforced neck. We are using the Waverly 3-on-plate tuning machines with the snakewood buttons on it, and they just made it really nice. What else have we done this year? It's got the 38 Songwriters Festival logo here on the back, as well as the year 2020. Or I build one of these guitars every year for the 38 Songwriters Festival, which is down here in the panhandle of Florida. It's an event that I also perform in. And we auction it off, and the money goes to the Cultural Arts Alliance of Walton County. Really great cause, and it's something that I really enjoy doing. I have to carve out about the last 3 months of the year to kind of get this guitar knocked out. Very, very pleased with how it sounds, man. We'll do a little something with the fingers here. Fretboard on this, it just has a beautiful beautiful projection. I can't get over how creamy it is. I really hope you guys enjoyed watching some of the final assembly steps that went into this guitar, and I hope to do a lot more videos like that capturing other aspects of the build. My hope is that the microphones that I used really did capture the sound of this guitar the way that it sounds here in person, and I hope to see you guys in the next video. I appreciate you. Thank you so much.